Hello everybody and welcome back, and thank you for time today as well for attending the second demo class. So today we will be starting our next topic, SAP CRM sales. So as I said yesterday, CRM can be divided into mainly three different parts. So CRM sales, CRM marketing and CRM service. Okay, so we'll start one by one and we'll see what are the different business processes and the functionalities provided within sales, service and marketing, and how the business and the end users are using the system on their day-to-day basis. Okay, so once we understand this, then we will move on to the customizing and we'll see what is happening behind the screen and how we can customize the different processes within sales, service and marketing. Okay, so we'll start today with sales. So today with sales, the topics we'll be covering today, they are: what is account management, account and contact management, and what is activity management, what is opportunity management, what is quotation and order management, and overview of the incentive and commission management. So these are the topics we will be covering today. Okay, so let us first start with account and contact management. Okay, so what is account and contact management? Okay, so account and contact management. Okay, when I say, let me write down here, when I say account and contact management, okay, so when I say account, it means that customer account. Okay, we do create a customer account in our system, so that means customer account, okay, or customer details. Okay, when I say contact, contact means contact person working at the customer side, okay, at customer end. Okay, this is your contact person. Okay, so the person working at the customer side. Okay, so first we'll see how we can set up an account in the system. Okay, how we can set up one account in the system. Okay, so let me log into CRM first. You will be given the ID as well. Sales professional. Okay, here I show you, first I will show you how you can search for the existing account. Okay, for example, if I click on this account management, okay, and here that is a search screen. Okay, if I click on this search accounts, and here this is a search screen. Okay, and here you have different filter criteria. You can filter when you're searching for an account. For example, I can search for an account where the customer name starting with, say, XYZ. Okay, I'll put XYZ star. Star means give me everything which is starting with XYZ and click on search. So that these are the customer setup with name starting with XYZ. For example, if I pick this one, XYZ company, here you can say this is XYZ company, that's the street address, country, city and all that. Okay, their email, maybe you can have a website. Okay, and here you can see different activities happening with this customer. Okay, I'll come back to this activity in a minute, but this is how you can search for account. Okay, if I go click on back, and if I search for, say, ABC customer, okay, there's a lot of dummy customer setup. If I say ABC star, click on search, it will give you all the customer starting with ABC. Okay, these are the customer. Okay, these are my customers. Okay, so that's ABC America Inc. America's Inc. And this is the address, phone number, you can have fax, email, whatever you want. Okay, so this is how you can search for existing account. Okay, but what if you need to create a new account? How we can create a new account? Okay, so if I click on account management again and click on click create, this is a create button, this is a search button, search screen. Okay, under create I click on corporate account, click on corporate account, and here I can enter a name of the company. Okay, I can say maybe Pepsi is my customer, so I'll say Pepsi Drinks Limited, whatever you want to call it. Okay, here I can enter a address. Okay, so I can say this number is say 123. Okay, or the location number, you can say ABC Street. Okay, here you can say postcode, say I'll say 3000. Okay, here you can enter a city, I'll say Melbourne. Here you can enter a country, you can search for the country from here and say AU, or enter create a Australia customer. Okay, and same way I can press enter now. If there's any error, it will tell me there's no error. Here I can enter the email address. Okay, I'll say okay Pepsi at pepsi.com, something like that. Okay, their website, you can open a link, okay, pepsi.com, or you can say http proper link, okay, / pepsi.com, okay, and all that. Okay, and I can save it, click on save button. And it will generate a number for me. To generate a number for me. Okay, it generated this number for me, 4000017, a big number. Okay, and here you can do some other stuff. For example, you can assign it a role. If I click on edit list, you can assign it a role. So role can be like, this can be a bill to party, this can be a ship to party, this can be a sold to party. Okay, there's a big chapter again, we'll come back to the customizing, we'll discuss about the different types of roles and how to customize them. But in brief, if I tell you that what is role, okay, role means we have so many types of roles, okay, but I'll tell you the common types of role. For example, I have sold to party. Okay, sold to party, there are four types of main role: sold to party, ship to party. If you have no background in SAP, then this is something new for you. Bill to party. In SAP SD, the concept is same. And payer. Okay. So, we have these roles are common roles used in all SAP system. So, sold to party means the customer who will be placing an order. Okay. For example, Pepsi is my multinational, is a company, multinational company, and they all over the world. Okay. So, their office in US, office in US, they will placing an order. Okay, so for the US based customer Pepsi, I have number 1234. Okay, so customer number 1234, which is Pepsi US, they will place an order. They are sold to party. Okay, then they will say that, okay, send my goods to Australia. Okay, customer number 4567, for example. Okay, send my goods to Australia. And they can say, okay, send the all the invoices, the billing document to say UK. Okay, where the customer number is 3456 again. Okay, and they can say that, okay, my company in Singapore, my branch in Singapore, they will pay for your bill for the invoices. Okay, and there is a number, put any number like that. Okay, so this is the role of sold to party, ship to party. So one same company can place an order, but they will say ship it to my different plant. Okay, and send the invoices to my another office, and my fourth office will be paying you for the billing document. Okay, and most likely they are same. They can be different, but most likely they are same. So only the same customer is placing an order. They said send the goods to me as well, and send the billing document to me as well, and my company, the same company, same office will pay for the invoices. Okay, these are the roles. So here we need to select a role. So here I will select a role. Say I'll say build a sold to party. There are so many, we'll discuss in more detail later on. But for now, I will select sold to party. Okay, this is sold to party. main customer activity. Okay, and I will save it. Okay, therefore, there are so many settings under, you can see these are the assignment blocks. So as we go further in our training, we'll discuss about all of them as the time comes. Okay, but here what we're learning is how we can set up a customer account. Okay, now our customer account is ready and the number is this 400 something. Okay, that's how you can set up a customer account. Okay, and I already shown you how you can search for your accounts or customer account. Okay, so this is your customer account. This is how we set up. Okay, now what we're learning today in this chapter, starting from sales, service, marketing, partner channel, field application, analytics, web channel, interaction centers, up to 10 topics. Here we will be learning more about the business processes and the functionalities provided by SAP CRM. Okay, we understand how the business or the people using the system. Unless we do not understand how the people are using, we cannot start learning customizing. Okay, if I show you how to customize a system, you will not understand anything because you don't know what are the functionalities within CRM. Once we understand the functionality, then we'll understand the customizing, what is happening, or how to change the setting behind the screen. Okay, so in these first 10 topics, which will take us probably another, saying if there's a 2.5 to 3 hour class, it will take us about 3 more classes, okay, to complete the first 10 topic. Okay, then we will move on to the topic number this 11, and all the topics starting from here onwards are basically your customizing. Everything is customizing. From starting from 11 up to 28. Okay, so we'll first stick to this one. Okay, and also what I'm showing you here is how we can create customer, how we change customer, how we can search for a customer. These are the functionalities. Do not run by the SAP CRM consultant. Okay, these are the functionality. We're not creating the customer. We not creating the contact, we not creating the sales order. Who is creating that? End users. The end users who are working in that company, who is using SAP CRM. Okay, so what we are supposed to do, how they are using, because we want to learn customizing. Okay, so this is what learning, how people are using, but at the end, we will not be using. But we need to understand how the system is used, because we want to learn customizing, right? Okay. Now you understand how we can create contact, how we can search contact, okay, then, sorry, account, not contact, account. Now we'll talk about contact. What is contact? Okay, so contact is your contact person working at the customer side. Okay, so for example, I'm working and my company is using SAP CRM. My company is ABC Limited, for example. Okay, now one of my customer is say Toyota. Okay, for example, okay, Toyota Limited. Okay, now when the people, the sales people will be from here, we have sales people. Okay, they are interacting with Toyota people, right? They are interacting with Toyota people. So they're not interacting with the MD here. Okay, they're interacting with other people. For example, purchasing. Officer. Okay, so our salespeople are interacting with their purchasing officer. So their purchasing officer will raise a purchase order, which is my sales order. Okay, so who are these purchasing officers? They are contact. Okay, they can be purchase officer, they can be maybe production manager, they can be somebody else, they can be managing director as well. Okay, so how we set up these contacts in CRM, we'll see here. Okay, how we set up contacts. Okay, now we'll study about contacts. Okay, so let's see some practical. So I have created this account. Now I will create a new contact. See this contact assignment block. These are called assignment block. These little things. They are called assignment block. Okay, so contact. Okay, I will create a new contact. Okay, so to create a new contact, I can click on new. Okay, click on new. It will open one more screen for you. And here I can enter some title, for example, Mr. Okay, here I can say first name, last name, I'll say John, and here I can say Smith. Okay, if you want, you can enter date of birth and all that, which is not important, and I will only enter the important fields. And here I can say function. What is their function? Okay, their function is, this guy is purchasing officer, and department is, say, purchasing department. Okay, or just say purchasing department. Okay, you can enter their email. This is copying from the company email, so I can say john@pepsi.com. okay, you can enter their phone numbers if you want, okay, their mobile number and all that if you want, okay, fax number as well. Okay, once you are done, click on back button and it will create a contact ID for you. You can see it created a John Smith ID. Okay, I can save it. Let me save the changes, and I created a new ID called John Smith. Okay, anytime I can come back and click on John Smith to make any changes. I can click on John Smith and I can click on edit. Here you can make some changes if you want. For example, name, or there's something wrong with the address or the function, department. You can make any changes anytime. Okay, I can save it and I can go back. Okay, so this is how you can create a new contact. You can also add existing contact. For example, contact, maybe a person named called Alan. Okay, Alan is a contact for this customer, and there is another Pepsi set up in my system, and he is also a contact for the same. So Pepsi has two branches, for example. So I have created one branch here. We have an existing branch in the system already. So in that case, if you want the same person to be a contact person for different accounts, in that case we click on add. So add means I want to add already created accounts in the system. Okay, you will see this screen here. I can search, click on this search button, and I will search for that contact person. Okay, so here I'll say the first name is Alan, and search, and there's so many Alans here. So I can pick one Alan. I'll select this Alan, and so that means I'm linking an existing contact. Okay, I'm not creating a brand new one. I'm linking an existing one which is floating in the system. If you save it, you have two contacts here. You can see I didn't enter any function and department. I can do it anytime. Click on this Alan Brook and click on edit, and function, I can say this guy is a managing director, and department is management. Okay, I can, here I can enter email. Okay, alan@pepsi.com, and save it and go back. So you can see I have Alan created here as well. Okay, so this is how we can create our contact and account. Okay, so no one knows your accounts better than you will see SAP CRM. So quick and easy, find the display account. You can quickly find it. Okay, information about your contact person, companies and relationship. You can maintain the relationship, their companies. Okay, who are the contact person, what is the relationship, their purchasing officer, their sales officer, different view of accounts such as customer, contact, consumer, competitor. You can also maintain different roles, like this is the customer, this is a sold to party, this is a ship to party, this is a competitor as well. Okay, you can also have a 360 degree view of the customer. What that means is, if I open existing account, I remember a number, I will use that number is 421985. Once you have access, you can use the same number if you want. Open this study next education. I created this account before. So here you can see we have a couple of four contacts here assigned to this customer. Also you can say we have planned activities. So this is called overview page. Okay, And here you can see everything on one page regarding the customer, just like a brief overview of your customer. Okay. For example, who are the contact person for this customer? What are the planned activities for this customer? For example, there's a somebody created a customer visit appointment, task, appointment and all that. What are the open opportunities? If somebody created opportunity as a transaction, they will also appear here as a shortcut. You can click on any link, it will open that opportunity. For example, if I click on this opportunity link, it will open opportunity. Okay, this is opportunity. We'll discuss about opportunity in a minute again. And marketing attributes like that. Okay, so everything is here on one screen. There's other more things as well here, which we'll discuss later on, okay, in the customizing topic. So this is the overview page, okay, where you have everything on one screen regarding your customer. There is also another functionality we have called fact sheet. There's a thing called fact sheet. If I click on PDF fact sheet, there are two types of fact sheet. I will discuss more about it in the next topics. But if I click on PDF fact sheet, so what this fact sheet is, I'll do it again. Oh, yep, it's here. Okay, so what is fact sheet? What is fact sheet? Okay, so fact sheet is, okay, suppose I am the sales guy working in a company, okay, in this company, whatever company is, ABC, okay, I'm working for company ABC, and I'm the sales guy here, I'm the sales employee here, okay, and my mainly task is to see the customers every now and then, and bring more business to my company. Okay, so whenever I go and see my customer, okay, I need some sort of quick information. Okay, who are the contact people working there? What are the recent opportunities? What are the recent sales orders? Okay, what are the recent transactions? Anything or activities? Okay, so for example, I want to see this customer 421985. I need a brief overview. Okay, just a quick information that I can take along with me when I'm meeting the customer, so that when I'm facing the customer, I have some sort of information ready in my hand. So that is where your fact sheet will come into picture, fact sheet. Okay, you can download the fact sheet from clicking on more and PDF fact sheet. Okay, and it will download like something like this. You can see it will download the who is the name, these are the contact person, okay, their telephone extension, these are the relationship that we have set up for this customer. Okay, some other information as well. Okay, there's not much information in this one, but if I show you another one here. Okay, that's an old one. It try to bring the data from CRM and ECC as well. Okay, you can see these are the accounts. Okay, you can also get this, like what is the last sales order number, date of the sales order, last billing document number, last date, last delivery number, credit limit used by the customer, okay, any quotation for the customer, any sales order, last open 5 orders, okay, credit memo, other sales document, okay, debit memo, okay, net value, like some statistical figures, for example, net incoming orders in year 2013, okay, and the previous year, this is from the last year, so this year and the last year, okay, so far incoming value of the sales order, okay, and open net value of the sales. So you can see there's a lot of information here, a lot of information. So if I'm the salesperson, I'm going to meet a customer, I can just click on this button and I can take along the brief overview of this customer, okay, which is covered under fact sheet. So that's the use of fact sheet. Okay, we'll discuss about fact sheet again. There are two types of fact sheet. We'll discuss about this one again in the customizing topic. Okay, so that is your account and contact management. Okay, so if you have any questions so far regarding account and contact management, then please ask me before I move on to activity management. Okay, there's one question here. So the first question is, so the account ID that gets generated is a BP number, that's right. So the account ID that is generated here, whatever the ID is, For example, here is 421985. That is the BP number or business partner number. Okay, and we can set up our own ID. Like we don't want to see 421 series. We want to see say 100 something series. So we can set that up. So this is a part of customizing. Okay. Next is, do I need the help of an ABAPer for the basis for fact sheet? Yes. If you want to make any changes to the fact sheet, then yes, that will be done by the ABAPer because this is done by the programming. Okay. But if you know about smart form, this is a smart form, okay, which is done by the programming. And next question is, what is fuzzy search? Okay, well, let me show you again. This is something, this fuzzy search came into this this version of the this CRM version. Okay, but to be honest, I didn't find any difference. If you use this search or this search, I can't find any difference. So for me, it is same. Okay, next is a BP role mandatory in account creation? Yes, you're right. BP role is mandatory for account creation, and we'll discuss more about in more detail in the customizing topic. There's a chapter here which I show you. CRM account management. See this one? So once we reach this topic, here we have a separate topic just for roles. This one. See roles. Roles. Okay, so here we will talk about more details in roles. And next is what other file format other than PDF fact sheet are available? Okay, there isn't any other file format. This is a standard in the system. We have only one format, which is PDF. We don't have any other format like your Word or Excel, anything like that. So PDF is the only one we have. Next is, can you explain what is BP? Okay, so BP maybe, yes, BP means business partner. Okay, we'll talk about BP concept later on. But for now, because I was asked this question in the chat box, that's what I'm asking. So we'll discuss what is BP and all that later on. But in short, BP means business partner. So once we start some customizing topic, we'll talk about the BP concept later on. Okay. So business partner can be any contact, anything. Can be account, contact, employee. There's so many things that are covered under BP. Okay. So we'll discuss this one again later on. But BP means business partner. Next question we have is a fact sheet smart form or ad hoc form? It's a smart form. So as per the this version of CRM, it's a smart form. I'm not sure whether there's some changes for ad hoc form or not, but so far this is smart form. Okay, there's one hand raised, so let me unmute this one and then we'll continue. So yes, Birbal, you raised your hand, you can speak. Have you been?
Is it MN, the customer we SD or MN, like those stored in the customer master table?
Sorry, your voice is a bit slow. Can you say again, a bit louder?
Okay, is this BP same as the customer we SD?
Okay, well, okay. So let me unmute you so that there's no disturbance. So basically question is the same customer but we create in SD or ECC and CRM. Okay, so the answer is yes. Okay, you have SAP CRM, you have SAP ECC. I'm supposed to talk about this topic later on in the customizing, but quickly I'll tell you. So either you can create it here or here, they will flow to the other one. For example, if I create it here, it can be flown to the, if depending the customizing setting are there, it can be flown to the other system. And vice versa. Okay, you can create in one system, it will flow to the other system automatically. Okay, so yes, they are same. They can be same. Okay, so you can speak again. Yes, Birbal, you can speak again.
Okay, so what customer we have and a customer must be
Hmm.
We can see that in the CRM, right?
Yes.
Okay.
if they are replicated, if they are replicated. That's all from your side? Okay, all right, thank you. Okay, so these things, how we can replicate the CRM to ECC, ECC to CRM, where are settings, what we need to do, we'll learn everything later on in the customer. Okay. And there's another question, what version of CRM is this? 7, what EHP version? This is the version 7.01, EHP 1. Okay, EHP 1. Next question is, how can we get the table name from a particular field? Okay, we'll discuss about this maybe later on. This is too advanced, I would say, for today. But I already send a, like we do in ECC, we press F1 and we find the table name. So that's a way you can do it from GUI, not from Web UI. It's not possible from Web UI, you can do it from GUI. And I'll show you that later on. But also as a part of the study materials, I will be providing you this thing, CRM tables and guides. So here you have the most commonly used tables. You can see there's a big list here. Okay, so you'll get everything like this. Okay, another question, so let's carry on. And if you have any question, you can keep typing and I'll take once I complete this next topic. Okay, so far we have seen about contact and account and contact management. Now we'll see activity management. What is activity management? Okay, so with activity, we have different types of activities actually in the system. Okay, so activity means, for example, I'll show you here. If I click on activities, seek activities, we have these types of activity. Okay, we have basically five types of activity. So we'll discuss one by one. Okay, so here I will write down. Activity management. Okay, so under this one we have first one is appointment. Okay, what is appointment? Now again, I'm the sales guy working in a company and I'm going to see a customer, okay, regarding to show them a new product or talking about a new opportunity or maybe provide them a quotation, could be anything. Okay, that means I need to create an appointment in my calendar. Okay, so what I'll do, if I'm going to see a customer, I can click on this appointment, create appointment, see this one, create appointment. And here we have different types of appointment, just like the anyone, for example, this one. And here I can say meeting with customer, whatever, ABC, okay, for product XYZ, for example. Okay. And here you can, on the right-hand side, you can search your customer. For example, this is search button. And I can say there's a customer I set up here. I'll say the customer name is Study Next Education. I will say Study Star. Just give me everything starting with study. And there's the first one. There's a customer. It will pick up the customer here. Okay. And I can say the meeting starting at what time? I can say meeting starting at something like this, say 8:30 a.m. and ending at say 11 a.m. Okay, there are some errors, don't worry about the error for now. Okay, and I can save it. I can save it. So once you save a meeting appointment, okay, it will go and sit in your calendar. If I click on the calendar, see on the left-hand side, I can click on calendar. This meeting will appear over there. See, there's a meeting here. So this is my calendar for today. If I click on week calendar, month calendar, like that, so there's a meeting here. It will go and sit in my calendar. Okay. And if I go to my home page, you will also see it will be sitting here. See, I created just one now. It will be sitting here on my home page of CRM. Okay. So that's how you create an appointment. Okay. So hope you understand the meaning of appointment, why we're creating appointment. Okay, so once you create an appointment, whatever activity you're creating, so once we complete all of them, I'll show you, they will go and sit with the customer overview page. Okay, I'll come back to this in a minute. Okay, so that's your activity. Sorry, appointment. That's your appointment. Something has been changed. Okay, so that's your appointment. Then we have email. Email. Okay, we can also send an email to a customer. Okay, if I click on email and I can send an email to a customer. Here I can enter the, I can search for customer and all that, and I can type the email here. But the best thing to write an email is I show you here. Open your customer to whom you want to send your email. For example, I want to send an email to this customer. Okay, and you can see there's a email link here. See this one, email. If I click on this email link, it will straight away take me to the email creation page. See, like that. So you don't need to type it here. Okay, it will directly copy the email address. Okay, so I'll say regarding product 1234. Okay, so I'll say hello Mr. something. Okay, so regarding this is and that, whatever you want to type here, and you can click on send and it will send an email. But this is a demo system, it will go nowhere. But for now, if I click on send, it will just save it and will do nothing. Okay, so you can send an email from a system as well. Okay, so that's a part of activity. That is a part of activity. Okay. Then we have, so whatever activity you creating, okay, whatever activity you creating, whether appointment, email and others, that will do in a minute, they will go and sit in the overview page of your customer. So this is the overview page of customer. Okay, this is the overview page. Okay, and you can see if I scroll down, there's an assignment block called planned activities. See this one, planned activities, this one, planned activities. So whatever you're creating, you can see I just created one appointment and the description was this. I just created an email and the description was this. Okay, and these are the old stuff. So whatever I will keep creating any activity, they will come and sit here. Okay, and anytime you can click on any of the activity. For example, if I click on this meeting with customer ABC, you can open it from here as well with this link. And that's the one I just created before. I can click on edit and I can make some changes, whatever I want. Say I want to change the time, save it, save and back. So whatever activity you create, they will come and sit under this planned activity assignment block for this customer. Okay, for this customer. Okay, so then we'll talk about some other types of activity. Then we have interaction log. Okay, interaction log. So what is interaction log? Okay, again, I'm working in the company as a salesperson. Okay, I may be working in the service department, I can be working in the finance department, anywhere. Okay, and customer just called me 5 minutes before and I had a conversation with the customer. Okay, and I believe that this conversation is very important. Okay, and it should be stored in the CRM system. Okay, so that everybody can access it, everybody knows about it. Okay. So in that case, I will be creating an interaction log. Okay, interaction log. So you just creating a transaction for an interaction that happened. Okay, so you can either click on here, or the other way is you can also do it from the customer overview page. If I open the customer overview page, here, planned activities, click on new. Okay, and here you can select category you want to create. For example, I want to create interaction log. So I'll select interaction log here. It will open one more page. If you do it from the overview page, it will know the customer. You can see it will already copied the customer because it knows that you're doing it from the overview page of that customer. That means you're talking about that customer only. If you do it from the other screen, then you need to enter the account or the customer number. Okay. So here I will say interaction log. Okay. So I'll say, okay. Regarding quotation or sales order number, sales order 5678, for example. Okay, and here I can put my text. Okay, I'll say, okay, customer just called me and they said they want to add two more quantities into the sales order, whatever. Okay, and I can save and back. So that's interaction log. Okay, you can see this. That's the one. That's the one I just created regarding. Where is that? Yeah, this one. First one regarding sales order 5678. Okay, it will go and sit here. Anytime you can click on this link and you can open it. Okay, you can, and then there's a search functionality as well. I'll come back in a minute. And then we have, or as I said, you can click on activities. I can click on interaction log from here as well. But here, the drawback is I need to enter the customer number because system doesn't know who is the customer talking about. Okay, if you do it from the overview page of the customer, you should be fine. Then we have a task. Okay, task is more like a, I would say it's a to-do list or to-do thing, to do what you want to do. Okay, like a reminder type thing, that is task. Okay, task can be related to a customer, it cannot be related to a customer. Okay, so I can say that I can create a task, click on task, and I can pick first task. And here I can say, okay, it can be a like customer related task, it cannot be, it may be a personal task. Okay, for example, I can say, okay, call John or call Alan at 10 a.m. on 25th March 14. Okay, and here you can enter the customer name as well if you want to link a customer or if you want to leave it blank, that's fine. Click on save and back. So all your tasks will go and sit at your home page. If I go to the home page, you can see there are so many tasks here. Let me fix something in this one. If I click edit, I need to give it a start date and end date. If I let me enter the customer first. Okay, let me create a new one again. Click on new. For some reason there something has been changed. It's not showing me the calendar search screen here. Okay, let me do something else. If I go to the home page. You can see here is a calendar. And if I extend the date to say 2014, that's the old one, old task, save and back. So all your tasks will go and sit at your home page. It's like a reminder for you. Because every time you log on to the system, you can see your task here. Okay. So here you can see whatever is with the green light, that means they are due in the future. Whatever is in the red light, this is a red light. That means they are overdue. Okay, so the due date was in the past. Okay, so green means the due date is in the future. Okay, and if the due date is today, it will be yellow. For example, if I open this one, I change the due date to say today. Okay, I'll say 25/03/14. Seven back, this will be yellow. I think in server date is 22nd today. It will read the server date. So what I'll do, sorry, it's not 25, it's 23. See, that's yellow. So if it is due today, it will be yellow. If it is due in the future, it will be green. If it was due in the past, it will be red. Okay, so task will be work like a reminder. Okay, and in your task, if you entered a customer, so that will go and sit with the customer overview page as well. So that task will go and sit with the this under planned activity somewhere here. Okay, you can see I can click on collapse button to make it a small screen, and if you want to see, you can see there are different tabs again. Okay, under planned activity there's so many, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tabs, or I can click on expand to see a big screen only for activities. Okay, then we have Another one, visit plan. Okay, number five we have visit plan. Okay, what is visit plan? If I click on visit plan, so I'll say visit plan for next week. Okay, starting on maybe 24th 3 2014. Okay, so if I'm going to see a lot customer, because I'm the sales guy in a company and my task is basically to see customer every day. Okay, so I can create a visit plan, okay, for all the my visits. For example, here I can say, okay, tomorrow I'm going to meet this customer. Okay, I remember some customer ID, so I'll put that here straight away. Okay, instead of searching, click on insert. Here I'll say 421 985. Okay, I'm going to see this customer tomorrow. Then I'm going to see another customer 3271. So you can put some time here. Okay, for example, you can say, okay, I want to see this customer on Monday. Okay, full day I want to see this customer, all day I'm with this customer, on the second day I'm with this customer on Tuesday. Okay, and for 1 hour or this time to this time, like that. You can put a start time, you can put end at starting at this for this duration, 1 hour 30 minutes. Then I am with customer this 3233, for example. Sorry, 3270. Okay, and I can say this customer I will be meeting on Wednesday, and like that. Okay, so you can create a visit plan for all the customers straight away on one screen. Okay, that is your visit plan. Okay, I can save it. Okay, so these are the different types of activities you have, five. Okay, again I've shown you how to create an activity. Okay, now I'll show you how to search an activity. Okay, so if you want to search for it, click on activities on the left hand side here, click on activities again. That's a bit odd. Do it again. Activities. Not sure why it's showing screen like this. Let me open one more screen here. If I do it here. Yep, that's better. Sometimes it does that, I don't know why. Okay, so here you can, this is a search screen for activities. You can search by description as well, you can search by who created, you can search by so many things. If I open this on start date, end date, category, for example, in the category I want to search for say emails or appointments, so you can click select appointment, I can search for it. So these are all the appointments. Then you can say, okay, I want to search for appointment whose description starting with say test. I'll say test star. Search. Okay, so these are the result at the bottom that you're looking at, starting with test. Okay, so I can remove test. I can say, okay, no, I want to search for an activity with which is linked to account ID or a customer ID 421985. Okay, so they're just filters. I can search. So these are the appointments associated with this customer. Okay, and from the search result, whatever you want to open, you can click on that little link. For example, this is the one I just created, and you can work on it, whatever you want. Okay, so this is your five types of activities. Now you know that what are the activities types, where and why we're using it. Okay, the why question is very, very important. Every time we learn here something, whether customizing, whether whatever, we need to understand why. Okay, why and when we do it, that's the main thing. Okay, so these are activities, and also some other stuff with activities. With activities you have some option, like you can enter some text attachments and all that. For example, I show you here. any activity I can open. For example, I can open this call John. Okay, and here I can, you can see, you can enter some text here if you want. I can click on edit. Here I can enter whatever text you want. You can enter some text. Okay, another important thing here is you can attach a file as well. Okay, if I open the attachment, in any transaction in CRM, you can attach a file. Open attachment, and here click on this attachment button, and I can browse a file here from my desktop or wherever you want to browse. Okay, so I can pick, say, SAP resume, open that, and I can attach, and it will be attached here. So you can attach any type of file like Excel file, PPT, Word format, anything like this. Okay, now if I save it, so this will be saved on the server all the time. So anyone, anytime, they can come here, open the attachment by clicking on this little link, and we'll open that file. Open, and it's open for you. So that's the one. That's the file that I attached. Okay. So that's your activity. Okay. And also there's another thing regarding activity. We can also enter some partners here. If you want to add some parties involved, under parties involved, you can enter some activity partner, like who is employee responsible, who is activity partner. So we'll discuss about the partner later on again. Okay. And other thing is, with regards to appointment, okay, or activities in CRM, okay, we have, for example, in any company, my company is using SAP CRM, okay, but they also use some other database, for example, Microsoft Outlook, okay, which is most commonly used, or Lotus Notes, okay. So these tools we have for the database, different types of database, using the emails, in auto emails, and also your calendar and all that. Okay. So that means if I'm supposed to, so if I'm the sales guy in a company, I'm using this and I'm using this both. Okay. Now, if I'm supposed to create an appointment, so should I create my appointment in SAP CRM or should I create an appointment in here? Okay. If you say I should be creating all the appointments in CRM, then maybe sometimes I'm not using CRM, I'm only accessing this database, and if I look into the calendar of MS Outlook, I can't find any appointment because appointments were created here. Okay, I can't see them here. Okay, so either whatever I create here, I should be creating that here, right? Which is a duplicate work, which is a waste of time. Okay. This is where a thing called group pair integration comes into picture. Okay, it's called group where integration. We'll discuss about this one again later on in the middleware topic, but just a quick brief that what it can do. So using the group pair integration, you can integrate your SAP CRM and Outlook for these objects. You can integrate your contacts or contact person. You can integrate. So for example, we also create some email account here, right? Like a contact. We set up a contact. Like in our mobile phone, we also create somebody's contact ID, their phone number, their name, whatever. Okay, same way we do that here. We enter the email and all that. Okay, so you can create it in either this system or that system. It will be integrated. Okay, so you can integrate contacts. You can integrate your tasks or to-dos. Okay, and there's one more here. Appointments. So these three things you can integrate between CRM and Outlook. So doesn't matter if you're creating a task or appointment here or here, it will be integrated to the other system. Okay. Again, there are two types of integration which I'll talk about later on. One is automatic, one is manual. Okay. If you're using manual, then what you need to do is to click on calendar. And there's a little button here. See this little button? If I click on this little button, and it's asking me to do something because there's no Lotus Note Outlook in this system, it will do nothing. But all you do is you click this button, and that's it. It will sync all that these three things from here to here or from here to here. So it doesn't matter wherever you create, it will be synced. So you don't need to do the duplicate work in two systems. You can create, use any system for creation and you can sync it to the other system. Okay, so that's your group pair integration. This is what I'm showing you here. So this is your CRM. You created a CRM appointment. Okay, it will be automatically go, it can be automatically go and sit in the Lotus Note or Outlook calendar. Okay, so same for your appointments and your appointments, your task and your contact person. Okay, these things you can integrate. Okay, so this is the end of activity management. Okay, if you have any questions so far regarding activity management, please ask me before I move on to opportunity management. Okay, so let me take some questions here. Question is, can't we create accounts from Outlook via group integration? We can create your contact only, not account. No, not account. Because there's so many things associated with the account, which I'm going to show you in the next customizing topics, because I just shown a brief thing what you're supposed to know now. For example, I'll show you here. And those functionalities is not possible in Lotus Notes or Outlook. I'll show you here. If I show you one account here, 421985. Okay. Not only the name, address and their role. Okay, first thing is there is nothing called role in the Lotus Notes or Outlook. Okay, you can't create a role. Secondly, there's so many other things we need to create that I will talking about later on, which is covered under the sales area data. Okay, we'll study about this one later on in the customizing topics. But what are they? For example, their terms of payment, their delivery types and all that. Okay, for example, there you can say these are the things. For example, you can maintain their Incoterms. Okay, delivery priority, shipping condition, like that. Okay, so these are the things we also create. Okay, their pricing procedure, okay, their currency, so many things you can see here. So these things cannot be maintained in Lotus Notes or Outlook. So that is why we cannot create. And also there is no functionality to create. Okay. Next is, can I add any search criteria in the activity search screen? The thing is, if you're talking about, I believe you're talking about search something here or here, I think. I'm not sure. If you're talking about here, this search, if you want to add something. So whatever you see here, they are available in the standard system. Again, there are so many fields, they are hidden, okay, which we can activate, okay, as a functional person, which I'll teach you in the customizing later on, that we can activate here as a functional person. And you can use those search criteria as well. But if there is something else which is not available in the standard system and they are also not hidden, then it can be done by the CRM technical person only. Okay, as a functional person, we cannot create something of our own. Okay, so if anything need to create it, something like something from scratch, something brand new, something in the drop down button and all that, then we need to do it via the CRM technical guy. Okay, next is, does the interaction log is distinguished with any codes? Do we have kind of inbound outbound interaction in CRM? Yes, there are some other criteria we can do, like inbound, outbound, there's so many. We will talk about this one in the customizing, but for example, if I quickly show you that interaction log, if I create an interaction log again, you can create some more categories under interaction log. For example, if I click on interaction log, you can see one is called incoming call, interaction log, e-tick, outgoing phone call, or you can call whatever you want to like. Okay, and you can create your own in the customizing. That's what we'll study later on in the customizing. Okay, you can call whatever you want. Okay. Any other question? No question? Okay, let's then carry on to opportunity management. Okay, what is opportunity management? I believe we all know the meaning of opportunity. Okay, but just in case If you're not clear, then I will explain you what is opportunity. Okay. So what is opportunity? Again, from the sales perspective in a company, opportunities is where there is a provision to sell. Okay, where there's a chance to sell something. That's opportunity. Okay. If I'm working in my sales company, in a company in the sales department, I'm the sales employee or sales officer, sales manager, whatever. And if I came to know that, okay, there's a company, new company establishing in here. My, say, for example, I'm working in company XYZ. Okay, my company is selling hard disk, you know, the computer hard disk. Okay. And I came to know that there's a new PC company going to be established in my city or in my area. Okay, and they will be manufacturing some new laptops. Okay, that means I know that they, to manufacture the laptops, they need some hard disk. And my company is selling hard disk. I have an opportunity to sell them hard disk. Okay, to sell them hard disk. So in that case, I'll be creating an opportunity in the system. This is an opportunity. Okay, I'll give you another example of opportunity. For example, I'm working in a company and they're manufacturing the hard disk. Okay, and we already supplying the hard disk to a company called Dell. Okay, Dell is manufacturing the laptops and all that. And we're supplying the hard disk to Dell. Okay, from a long time. They are my existing customer. Okay, so I came to know from my links that Dell is going to launch a new laptop. Okay, with 18-inch screen. Okay, so far there is no 18-inch screen, but they will be launching a new size of the screen, 18-inch. Okay, so I know that, because I'm already providing them hard disk from their other sizes of the laptop, that means there's a chance that I can sell them more hard disk, okay, for their new product or 18-inch laptop. So that's where the opportunity will come into picture. Okay, so now you understand the opportunity. Let's see some practicals. Okay, so before that, the meaning of opportunities. An opportunity is a recognized possibility for a company, for example, to sell a product or service. Okay, as I said, there's a possibility where you can sell a product or can be a service as well. Okay, the opportunity allows you to view sales project from very start and track the progress. Okay, we'll discuss about this in a minute. Okay, so if you want to create opportunity, click on sales cycle, and here we have opportunity. This opportunity, create opportunity. Okay, you can see there are so many types of opportunity. So you as you know, a lot of students, they keep practicing, they create their own. Okay, they put their name and all that. Okay, so you will be also creating something for yourself as well. And I do a cleanup every 3 or 4 months. Okay, so again, they've been collecting a lot, so I'll be doing the cleanup soon. So that's the one I created before, opportunity GS new. Okay, I'll be using mine. You can use mine, you can create your own. That's up to you. Okay, so select a type, opportunity. Okay, you selected opportunity this, and that's the opportunity overview page. Okay, most of the overview pages look same. Okay, they look similar, but they're different. For example, this is opportunity on the top. Okay, here I can say opportunity to sell hard disk for 18-inch PC, for example. Okay, here I can enter the prospect. Okay, and remember a code, I can directly enter the code or you can search for it. Okay, I can enter a sales stage. We have different sales stages. I can pick any sales stage. Okay, and there are two errors here. I need to make sure what are the errors. Okay, accidental. Okay, let me pick a different one, because I'll tell you in a minute why I'm picking a different one. Okay, I'll pick this one, standard one, OPASM. This is a standard CRM one. Okay, so here I'll do the same thing. Okay, opportunity to sell 18-inch, hard disk for 18-inch PC. Here I can type the 421985 as a customer ID. I can select a sales stage. Okay, there are different stages. As we progress the opportunity, we'll change the stages. Okay, and here I need to scroll down. That's my opportunity ready. There are three arrows. The array is saying you need to select a sales organization. Okay, so if I scroll down, open the sales at the bottom, organizational data here. Okay, ideally it should pick up the sales organization distribution channel automatically. Okay, but why it's not doing it, I'll tell you later on. But in the next topic, I'll show you how we can customize the system so that it can pick it up automatically. Okay, but for now, always and always when you practice on the server, always and always use this one, what I'm going to use. Okay, because there's so many here. So always use sales US here. Second one, always use 14. Here you always use 14, and here you use 00. Always use this combination. Okay, when you press enter, other things you can use anything. The top one and the bottom one, doesn't matter. You can use anything, but just use these three, and you will learn later on why I'm saying to use them. Okay, these three are important. Rest can be anything. Okay, so sales US 1400, always use this. Okay, and my opportunity is ready. Okay, so here I can enter some more detail. Okay, so that, okay, there's a new product going to be launched by company XYZ, and there's a probability to sell the opportunity like that. Okay, so you can enter a text. You can also enter the product ID. Okay, you can search for a product from here. Okay, I can say, okay, product description is hard disk star. Okay, there's so many hard disks. For example, I can pick one hard disk here, and I can enter a quantity, say one. Okay, there are two errors. I know why there are errors, because it's a mismatch in the sales organization. So I will be using a different product code. Okay, and the description will be only different. So just be with me. Here I will be using HT1010, because these codes I have set up with a proper combination so that there is no error when I'm showing you something. Okay, here I can enter quantity, say 100 or 1000, whatever you want to put the quantity. And see, there's no error. Okay, just assume that this is a hard disk. Okay, HT1010. And I can save this hard disk, this opportunity. So that's the opportunity I have saved. Okay, so I'm the sales guy. I created an opportunity and I will start working on it. Okay, start working on it. So I will go and meet with the customer, and I will say, okay, I will show you my product. Okay, and we making this hard disk for a long time, and they will be interested. And I can, as the time will go, as the opportunity will progress, I will keep changing the stages. So I'll say this is at this stage, at this stage, at this stage, at this stage, and this stage. Once it is finalized, I can close it. But for now, I can keep changing the stages. That means it's improving. It's going to next step, next step. And all these stages, we can customize. Whatever you see here, they are SAP standard. But whatever the business will want, they will be totally different. So how we can create our own drop-down, we'll study later on. Okay, in the customizing. But for now, I can pick any sales stage. That means the sales, the opportunity is progressing. Okay, and I can save it. Okay, so that's my opportunity saved. Okay, that's how you can create an opportunity. Okay, you can enter a product, and same way you can see it will copy your contact person automatically. So whoever customer you picked up, it will copy your contact person. It will also, you can also attach something here. See attachment? The same way I have attached something before, you can attach to this transaction as well. Okay, so you can also enter a competitor if you want. If you want to see that, okay, for this opportunity, there is a competitor we have. You can click on new competitor, new, and you can search for a competitor. You can assign a competitor. There's so many here, I will pick one. Okay, I can say their strength. What is their strength? Okay, their strength is this, whatever you want to say. What is their weakness? Their weakness is this. Okay, go back, and you can see there is a competitor assigned. So you can assign more than one competitor if you want. Okay, so these competitors are working for the same opportunity. Okay, so that's your opportunity ready. So that is how we create an opportunity. Okay, and same thing, if you want to search for an opportunity, okay, again, as I said before, you have different stages, different phases for the opportunity, okay, and you will go further one by one step, okay, one by one step, you will progress opportunity, you will progress opportunity, and at the end of the day, okay, what will happen is, you will either lose the opportunity or you will win the opportunity. Okay, either you win the opportunity, so whatever the result is, you can select a result here when the day arrived. Okay, you can change the status to won or lost. But in the meantime, you will keep progressing the opportunity. And finally, the result will be won or lost. Okay, won or lost. Okay, that's your opportunity. Okay, now if you want to search for opportunity, same way we have done it before. If I search for my numbers, opportunity number is 1679. I'll write down here. I created one opportunity, 1679. Okay, so if you want to search something, click on sales cycle, sales order, sorry, not sales order, opportunities, sales cycle, opportunities, and again you can search by different criteria like by description or by who is the employee responsible for that one, what is the distribution channel, sales organization, competitor ID, contact ID, a lot of things. Okay, so for example, if I search for by account ID or prospect ID, this is opportunity ID as well. So I can straight away say 1679. So there are different filter criteria. So you can set by customer, whatever status, by status, there's so many things here. And I can open my opportunity. Okay, that's your opportunity. Okay, any question regarding opportunity before we move on to quotation and order management? Let me take some questions. Okay, the first question, do I receive any email in CRM? Well, we can send email from CRM, but to receive an email, we have a different functionality, which I'll talk later on, but quickly I'll tell you. See the email inbox on the left-hand side? If I click on email inbox, what will happen is it can go and sync. It will go and show you the screen of your Lotus Notes or Outlook inbox. Okay, if I click on it, it will do nothing because there is no Lotus Notes here. But what will happen is it will show you the screen of your Outlook, okay, MS Outlook, and you can click on any email and you can transfer to CRM. So that's why you receive the email in CRM. So you receive it like indirect. You're not receiving, you're linking. Email will be received in your Lotus Notes or Outlook, but you're linking those received email to CRM. Okay, we'll talk about this one later on again. And then we have next question is, what is the significance of opportunity type? Okay, can I create without selecting it? Okay, so type is like a company can have only one type of opportunity. For example, if I click on sales cycle opportunity, okay, there are different types because as I said, different students creating their different IDs and all that. But in real-time scenario, you can have different type. For example, a company is say retail company or maybe a food company or whatever. Okay, they have different products. So they can create, say, one opportunity is called opportunities for electric items. Another opportunity is for opportunity for electronic items. Okay, or third opportunity is opportunity for online stuff. Could be anything. Okay, or it can be only one. Maybe company don't want to use the different types. They want to use only one. So that's also possible. So this is your opportunity type. Next is, what did you say about grouper integration? Sorry, I missed it. Nothing, grouper integration is nothing. Using the grouper integration, you can sync your activities. You can sync your tasks. You can sync your contacts. You can sync your appointments. Okay, with Lotus Notes or Outlook. Okay, so this chapter will be covered in more details in the middleware topic later on. Okay, that's what your grouper integration is. So you don't need to create the same thing in two different systems. okay, which is like waste of time, as I said before. So we can either create an appointment in CRM or create in the Lotus Notes or Outlook, and using the GroupWare integration, it will be synced. Next question is, what is the difference between opportunity and lead? Okay, good question. Opportunity and lead are basically similar, but opportunity word is basically used for the sales department in within a sales scenario. Okay, and lead word is used in the basically in the marketing scenario. Okay, so we'll do the marketing topic later on, hopefully next week. But as you're asking this question, so what happens is we have a marketing department in a company as well, right? We have marketing department. So what they do is they have they create their daily campaigns, okay, or launching new product or launching promotions, and they keep sending an email or maybe washer or something, or by post to the or SMS to the different prospective customers. Okay, so for example, they send an email to say 10,000 customers or 10,000 people that we providing 50% discount on our product ABC. Okay, so some of those customers might reply them back, okay, that I'm interested. Okay, so what marketing department will do, they will create a lead. Like opportunity, they will create a lead. Okay, so this is again opportunity, but for them, they will call it lead. Okay, and they will create a lead and send it to sales department. And what sales department will do? Sales department will convert it to an opportunity. That's what lead is. Okay, so lead will become an opportunity later on. Okay, any other question before I move on to our next topic? If you have missed any class, any part of our class today or yesterday, I will be sending you the recording. And for yesterday class, as you know, my internet was dropping off. So the last half of the recording was not recorded, only the first half. Okay. But I'll send you another link from where you can see that topic from my previous batch. Okay. So whatever you have missed, you will get the recording, especially for today as well. Okay. So let's carry on. Next we have is, there's one more question here. Let me take this. While we are discussing the various topics, can you let us know the tables where this opportunity, product, etc. are stored? As I said before, if you look at the last attachment here, so I'll be giving you this attachment as a part of the training material where you have all the list of all the tables. Okay, so everything will be given. Okay. So let us start our next topic, which is quotation and order management. Okay, what is quotation and order? Okay, let us discuss with quotation. Okay, so quotation is nothing. Quotation is your legally binding offer, okay, to deliver specific product or a selection of a certain amount of product to in a specified time frame at a predefined price. Okay, in simple words, what that means is I'm working with an ABC company. And when I'm providing a quotation to a customer, for example, you guys, okay, you want to buy a laptop. Okay, what you'll do, you will go to a shop number one. You will say, okay, give me a quotation. I want to buy a Dell laptop. Okay, you'll give me a quotation. You'll go to a second shop. Okay, give me a second quotation. Okay, so you will find the quotation from a couple of people. Okay, then you will finalize which one I want to buy. Okay, so whoever is giving you that quotation, they will give you a product, a price, okay, and a valid due date. They always have a validity date, okay, and within this validity period, they are legally binded. They are legally binded to give you the same price. Okay, they can't change their word. So until that validity date, so whatever the date they put until next week, next month, whatever, they are supposed to pay you, give you the same product at same price. Okay, that's your quotation is. Okay, we all in real time scenario also we all. Have quotation. We want to buy something. We try to find a better quotation. Okay, that's what quotation is. Okay, so how to create a quotation in CRM? Similar as we have seen in opportunity. Click on quotation. So there's so many here. I'll pick AG, which is a standard one. Okay, so here I can enter sold to party 421985, enter. and I can enter. There's some errors here. Don't worry about the error for now. And I can enter product here, ST1010. Quantity, say 10, enter. Okay, same way we had. So it has a valid to date. So until this valid to date, I am legally binded. So the structure of this transaction is similar to opportunity, but this is called opportunity on the top. Okay, and I can save it. I can save it. Okay, and also I can, as with the, as per the other transaction, you can enter some notes here if you want. You can enter some notes here. Some notes here if you want. Okay, save. Okay, and same is the case for sales order. Okay, this is your quotation. If you want to get a sales order, same thing. Go to sales cycle. Create sales order. And there's so many sales order. I'll pick the standard one. Okay, I need to do some cleanup here. As you can see, there are so many here. But for now, TA is the standard one. TA is the standard SAP standard sales order. Stack TA. And same thing. 421985. Okay, press enter. And product ST1010. Okay, it looks so simple here, but when you learn customizing, there are a million things you need to learn. They're so big in from customizing point of view. Okay, so that's how you create a sales order. Okay, but we have an option. We're setting quotation and order management. Okay, we have an option where we can convert a opportunity, okay, to a quotation if you want. So that means once I have the opportunity, I don't need to create a quotation. I can convert the opportunity to a quotation. I can convert this opportunity to a quotation. Okay, how to do this? I'll show you. There's some more errors. Let me cancel this. Okay, I'll open my opportunity that I just created before. Okay, that's the opportunity I created. Okay, so if you want to convert your opportunity to a quotation, the main thing is there should be no error in your transaction. See, there's no error. This is a warning, don't worry about it. No error, red error should be there. Okay. And then when you want to convert it to a quotation, what you do is to click on see create follow-up. If I click on create follow-up, that means I want to convert this opportunity to a quotation. And here I will select a quotation. See this one, sales quotation. I want to convert to a sales quotation. Select sales quotation. Here it is asking me in this pop-up, it's asking me which item from the quotation you want to copy to, which items from the opportunity you want to copy to quotation. Okay, which item from the previous transaction you want to copy to the next transaction. Okay, because there was only one item, so that's why showing one. If there are 10, it will show you 10 here. And you can select whatever you want. I'll select this one because there's one. I'll select one and click on choose. Okay, once you're done, there's one error here. Let me check. Enter service organization. Let me enter the service organization and we'll save it then. So by just clicking on the create follow-up button, you don't need to create a brand new one. You can just convert it. You can link it. So all these sales organization should be picked up automatically. We'll learn later on. But for now, just pick this one, what I'm picking here. Oops, there's something wrong. Okay. Okay, I'll find my opportunity again. These are the recent items. I need to search from here. Sales cycle, opportunities, and opportunity ID. One, six, seven, nine. Open that. Okay, create follow-up. I want to convert it to a quotation. And here you can select sales quotation. Select that. And select one item from previous transaction. Choose. There's one error. Just leave the error for now. Save it. Okay, saved. So you can see I have saved. I have converted a quotation opportunity to a quotation. Okay, by clicking on the follow-up button. Okay, so what that means is system will create a quotation automatically. Okay, and it will do a link between opportunity and quotation. Okay, where is the link? If you open the transaction history here, you can see the link. So this is a quotation which I just created, which was a follow-up from a opportunity, this one. Okay, so here you can see that this opportunity is coming from, sorry, this quotation is coming from this opportunity. Okay, so again, if I click on this link of this opportunity, so this opportunity will also show you, this opportunity will also show you the same link. Okay, that's opportunity we created before. And here, if I open the transaction history, so you can see under transaction history, it will link the quotation that I just created. Okay, so it's called conversion or a follow-up. Okay, so we can create as a follow-up. So when you create as a follow-up, you don't need to enter the same data again. Okay, so I'll do it again. If I create another follow-up, I don't need to do the data entry again. I can save some time using the follow-up. And the good thing is system will maintain a link between both. Okay, so I'll select this one. So that's it, done. You select the item and you are done. That's it, save it. So I created two quotations from one opportunity and it will link them. If I go to this opportunity, under transaction history, you can see there are two now because I created two quotations as a follow-up. Okay, so same way you can also link a quotation to a sales order as a follow-up. So all the link will be maintained like this. As a follow-up. Okay, so if you want from the quotation, if you want to, so I have the quotation number this 5002376. Okay, so how this link is maintained, this is customized behind the screen. Okay, they will run in the customizing that how we can maintain, what should be allowed to be controlled and what should not be allowed. Okay, we'll see that later on. So if I open this quotation here, first I need to make sure there is no error. Okay, there should be no error if you want to create a follow-up transaction or a sales order. Open the organizational data. It's asking for a service organization. Edit. Let me select something. Okay, there's no error now. Okay, now if I save it, now this is a quotation I created as a follow-up. Again, if I click on follow-up, I can now select, go to the next screen. You can create as an activity as well, or you can create a sales order, a sales transaction. Okay, if I select the sales order, it will copy the data here to the next transaction. There's something changed in the customizing. You can see it's not picking up the customer here. It's not picking up the customer here. That is wrong. Okay, it should pick automatically the customer, but let me try to save it if I can. No, I can't save it. Okay, so it's not saving because it's not automatically picking up the customer. I know what is wrong. Okay, I need to fix that in the customizing. I'll do it later on. But as you can see that we can do a follow-up. Okay, and we can link them all together. Okay, we can link them all together. Okay, so this is your quotation and order management. And with regards to quotation and order management, sales order, what is sales order? You know what is sales order is a request from the customer to the company to deliver a certain amount of products at a certain time and to provide a service by a certain time. Okay, it can be a product, it can be a service. Okay, that is a request in your sales order. Okay. Now, sales order scenario with the integration between CRM and ECC. Okay, I think I did show you this screen before as well, yesterday as well, but anyway, I'll show you again. So, as I said yesterday, you have your, here you have SAP ECC CRM. On the other side, you have SAP ECC. Okay, so here you can create a sales order in CRM. And it will automatically flow to ECC. Okay, it will automatically come to ECC in SD. Okay, why we need to send it to SD? Because CRM doesn't provide any logistic process, any delivery process. And if you're using a sales order and having a physical item that needs logistic, then we need to connect it to any ERP system. Okay, so not for service product, only for sales product or physical products. So you will create a sales order here. It will automatically flow to ECC. And then here you can do the logistic process like delivery, okay, picking, packing, and all that. Okay, and once you are done, then final step is your billing. So billing can be either done here or billing can be either done here. Billing can be done in either system. That is optional. So we'll talk about this one again in the billing later on. So, but delivery has to be done in other system. Okay, so that's your screen. So as I was showing you transaction yesterday, that once the order is delivered in the ECC system, it will send a notification to CRM. So here your CRM, here is your ECC. You created a sales order in CRM. It will be flown to ECC. You will do the delivery, picking, packing, transportation, logistic, everything here in ECC. Finally, the billing can be done here in ECC or can be done in CRM. Okay. So that's your sales order processing. So as I shown you something yesterday, old transaction which was showing all these activities. So that's the old sales order, and here you can see shipping transaction. So these are the shipping transaction. So these are the shipping outbound delivery goods movement done in ECC, and the notification was sent to CRM that this is my document number, this is my document number, like that. Okay, same with the billing. So that's the billing document. So information sent to CRM. Okay, so we'll discuss about them in detail in the customizing again. Okay, so any questions so far before I move on to the contract management? So any question regarding quotation and order management or whatever we have done so far? So let me take some questions. Do we get to see the tables in SAP CRM? You need to go to GUI. Okay, not in the web UI. You need to go to GUI to see the tables. Okay. Then we have a question is, so what is the transaction? SC16, same as SAP SD. SC16 is the transaction for tables. Next is, can we create inquiry too? Okay, I think you're asking inquiry because you have seen that in SD. Okay, in SD you have seen inquiry. So in CRM is like a big brother of SD. Okay, it provides a lot of millions of advanced functionality which doesn't exist in SD. Okay, and inquiry is a very small thing. So you can think of like in CRM, inquiry has been converted as an opportunity. We can call it opportunity, but and there's nothing called inquiry in CRM. But for any reason you want to create an inquiry, yes, we can customize. That's not a problem. But inquiry is not there as a standard in CRM, but we can customize inquiry as well. Then next question is, can we keep a document as quotation inside CRM? I didn't get your question, but if you're talking is if you want to attach a document, then yes. Any transaction, in any transaction, you can attach a document as I was showing you before. For quotation. Quotation. Let's see, done. Attachment. Under attachment, you can attach anything you want, like I have attached before. So here you can attach anything. I think this is what you ask. If not, then please ask me. Next question is, sometimes I send customer a quotation, but he asked for a discount. So I added the quotation and send it again. So now I have many versions of the same quotation. Can I save the version? Well, this can be, you need to think how you want to customize it. Okay. If you're talking about the different version, if you want to use a different version, then what I would advise you to do is to use this process, follow up. Okay. What you will do in the case of follow up, what you will do, you will have quotation. So you created first quotation, 1, 2, 3, whatever, one. Okay. Then they ask to change something. You can create a follow up. Okay. As a quotation number two. Okay. They will be linked together. And this is your second one. Then you can create a third one if you need. And they all will be linked together. So this way you can create different version. And they will be linked together as well. Next question is, does CRM sales order billing transfer to ECC through batch or real time? It happens in real time. So if you create something in CRM, it will be thrown to other system just in 1 second. Next is, CRM will support MM scenario like purchase order and payment process. Do we receive inbound delivery notification too? We just receive notification, but it doesn't support any MM, any logistic, any PP processes. Okay, but we only receive the notification which is linked to the delivery processes, like your goods movement, PGI document number or the delivery, outbound delivery number and all that. Next is, and how end user will receive communication from CRM like EDA and IDOC? And how end user will receive communication? Well, CRM, from the EDA and IDOC perspective, CRM has exactly same functionality. Okay, if you in the SD using EDA and IDOC and all that for sending notification, in CRM you have the same thing, which you can use. Next is, do we have configuration setup like ECC SPRO? Yes, we do have that, which I'm going to show you later on. But if you're asking now, I'll show you here. So again, here, this is the CRM screen. You go to SPRO, press enter, SAP reference IMG, and the same, similar view, but a different screen. Next question is, can we directly convert a lead to opportunity? Yes, we can. Like I have converted opportunity to quotation, same way we can customize and we can create, we can convert a lead to opportunity. Next is, delivery notification can be sent by email or something to CRM. I mean, how user will know that order is delivered, for example. Well, what you're asking is, if you want to send a notification to CRM, then it will be here in the CRM transaction assignment block, you can see the notification. But if you want to send it to a particular person, that will be something customized. Okay, this is not available in the standard system, so we need to talk to the program and all that, that how we can send the notification in that case. Okay, because this is not standard. Okay, but yes, it is possible. Okay, so okay, next is, thanks for all good answer. Okay, no worries, thank you. Okay, another question before we move on to the next one, which is contract management. And I think we nearly half of the time, so probably let us take a break, okay, 3-4 minutes break, and then we'll come back and start the next topic, contract management. Okay, so I'll be back in 3-4 minutes. Okay, so let us get ready. Hope everyone is back. Okay, now we'll start contract management. What is contract management? So what is contract? As you might know that contracts are long-term agreements with customers that follow them to buy products under special conditions such as lower price or favorable terms of delivery. Okay, so in simple word, what is contract? Contract is when one of my customers will come and say, okay, I'll be buying they will be buying from my company, say, for the next 2 years. Okay, so whatever product they're buying, they will make a contract with my company that, okay, they will buy the same thing from my company only for the next 2 years, but they want something in favor. Okay, or maybe they want some special discount. Okay, or maybe they want the delivery to be done at their plant or something like that. Okay, so because my company is getting a big contract, I'll say, okay, no worries, I'll give you some 5% discount, 6% discount, and we'll have a 2 year contract. Okay, so that's your contract. So with contract, so how to create a contract? So same as we have done before with like other transaction, I'll click on to refresh. Sales professional. Okay, I need to click on sales cycle, and here you can see sales contract. Okay, that's a sales contract, and we have two types of contract again. Basically, we have, you can say, okay, one is your quantity contract. Okay, where the customer will say, okay, we will be buying you from me, they will be buying from my company in the next 2 years of maybe they're buying say hard disk. Okay, they will be buying say 100,000 pieces of hard disk. Okay, that's quantity, they're talking about the quantity. Or they can say that there's a second type of contract which is called value contract. Okay, that means they will be buying from my company in the next 2 years worth of say $50,000. Okay, they'll buy, so value. Okay, they'll be buying the product of this much value, or they can be talking about the quantity. Okay, so the creation of the transaction is similar. What you do is to click on this create sales contract and pick a sales contract here. For example, you can say quantity contract. I can select a quantity contract, and the rest of the things are same. For example, sold to party, I'll enter the same number that I was using before. Okay, and I can enter some product here as well. Okay, I can say, okay, ST1010 is a product. I'll use the same product and target quantity. Okay, how much quantity they want to get is say 100,000 or whatever number you want to put here. That's it. Okay, and I can save it. Okay, and from the contract, okay, from the contract you can start releasing the order. Okay, if it is customized, that means I've created a contract here in my system, contract number, say sales contract, you can call it sales contract or quantity contract, whatever. Okay, from the sales contract we can start releasing the sales order. Okay, that means from here we can create a sales order number one. Okay, so sales contract was of say quantity 100,000. Okay, pieces. So sales order number one we can create for say 1,000 pieces. And we can again next month we can create another one of a sales order to second sales order. This can be of say 5,000 pieces like that, and so on and so on. So you're releasing the sales order from the contract. Okay, let me check if it is working in this system. Create follow. And forward. No, it's not. It's not customized. It's not customized. Let me check if I can find an existing contract. No, nothing here. You can see there's a thing called release history. So whatever you release, they will come and sit here. Okay, if I say release history show all, there's nothing in this one. Let me try if I can find another one. No, there isn't any release history, but if you want, we can use this functionality. Okay, or if you want to use a standalone contract, that's also possible. Or if you want to use a release strategy, you can release the order as a follow-up, as we have done before. Well, when we created a follow-up as a quotation from an opportunity, like that, same way. Okay, so you can release them. So that's a contract. That's a contract management. Okay. And then we have, so that's all about your contract management. So again, as I said before, The structure of the transaction, most of the transaction, whether it's a contract agreement, contract or a quotation opportunity, lead, service order, they all look similar. Okay, just a little bit different, but the structure of the transaction looks similar. Okay, and so that's about the contract management. Okay, and then I will give you an overview of the incentive and commission management. Okay, but before that, let me take some questions. Question is, you just logged on in CRM SPRO using CRM Web UI. I mean the same web URL, right? I just saw I'm good thing. Okay, I think you got the answer. That's fine. Okay. Next question is, in value contract, do I have to enter material? If yes, which material should I use, because I don't know which material I will sell to customer? Well, for the moment, yes, you can enter the material. Yes, you can. But for the moment, there are so many materials set up in the system. Okay, but what I, and they all materials have some sort of setup behind the screen. Okay, that we'll learn later on in those topics. Okay, but for now, once we have the access to the system, you should be using this material all the time. Because I have set up this customer in a perfect manner so that it will match with most of the transaction. If you use some other materials, then it can cause some sort of errors and all that. Okay, and you will understand those errors as we move to the next topics in the customizing. Okay, but for now, just use this one. But we can create our own product as well, whatever we want. So we'll talk about it in this chapter. Chapter number 15, Product Master. Okay. I mean in live case, because I don't know in future which material customer will ask. I'm not sure what you mean by in live system, what they will ask. Well, if how can you create a contract unless you have finalized the material with the customer? You can't create any transaction unless the material is finalized. Right? In the live system, you cannot create anything unless you have finalized a contract or something with the customer. Okay, if I misunderstood, then please explain your question again. You said there are two types of contract. I knew the sales contract and service contract, but the one you mentioned is different. Well, there are some other types as well, but the one I mentioned are basically two common types. Okay, what you're saying is, as we have a sales scenario, we can have a service scenario. So in service as well, we can have a quantity. In service, we cannot have a quantity one. In service, we can have a normal contract. But from the sales point of view, we have mainly two contracts. And if you're using the service industry, then we can have a different types of contract. Again, there are some other types of contract, but these are the major one. These are the major one. Okay. In service, because in service, you can also use the same logic. You can call it sales or service quantity contract. Okay. And you can call the same thing to this one. Okay. So these are the division further of the contracts, nothing else. Next question is, will there be notification when the contract ends or expire? Like say, quantity agreed has reached. Yes, that's right. We have a functionality in the system which is called action profile. Okay, topic number 19 here. Okay, which can control this type of thing. We'll talk about it detail later on. But what it can control is, for example, like you asked, that we can customize a new action profile that can send a notification to a person who is the owner of the contract, okay, or who created the contract, and when the contract is going to expire within next 2 weeks. Okay, so we can automate those processes using the action profile. So action profile can send an email to the person responsible or the sales or employee responsible for your contract 2 weeks before the expiry date, or whatever date you can fix, 3 weeks before, 1 month before, whatever. Okay, so that can be done, yes. And we'll discuss in chapter number 19. Next is, can I use a text material or something in value contract? Not really, no. I think you're talking about with SD. In SD, you can use text, like you can enter some text, but not in CRM. It doesn't provide text. It has to be a real material setup in the system. So in SD, yes, but not in CRM. Okay, so let us complete our last topic within sales. Okay, and overview of incentive and commission management. Okay, here I will just give you an overview. Okay, and what this functionality is all about. Okay, there is no practical in this one. There is a functionality in CRM which is called, known as incentive and commission management. Okay, now you might know that CRM is, as I said yesterday, CRM is very, very big. It's an ocean. Okay, there are so many advanced functionality or advanced subtopics within CRM. Okay, and if you want to learn everything, it will take you 2 years just for the training. Okay, and maybe still you can't complete everything. Okay, so there are some advanced topics like if you heard about trade, promotion, management. Okay, and then we have some others like this one, incentive and commission management. Okay, then we have case management. Okay, then what else we have? What do you call it? Can't remember the names, not coming to my mind. There's some couple more. Okay, so these topics, okay, we cannot cover all the topics. Basically, the purpose of this training is to understand the basics of CRM. This is from the basic to mid-level training, not the advanced training. Okay, but anything like this one, I will tell you the overview, what that means, what they do. Okay, so within this one, even if you want to learn this one, this will be another 20-30 hours of training itself. Okay, same with this one, same with this one. Okay, so as I said, there's endless learning. So same is the case here. I will tell you about incentive and commission management. So what is incentive and commission management? So there's a functionality in CRM which is known as incentive and commission management. So what that is, so basically what happens is, if you look at this picture on the right hand side, okay, this is a corporate or the company objective, company goal. Okay, under that we have an individual goal. So company goal is to bring more business. Say in the next 1 year, the company wants to bring, say, $1 million business. Okay, extra business to the company, to the corporate. Okay, then what they do is they divide the target to individual people. Okay, so say, okay, Alan, your target is $100,000 of value, you need to bring the business. Okay. Person number two, you have this target. Person number three, this is your target. Okay. So ultimately, they all working, all the salespeople working on the individual target, but ultimately that is the company target. Okay. So we have a functionality in CRM called incentive and commission management. Using this functionality, we can customize the commission. What that means is, so you can see these salespeople have their individual target. Okay, so company can say that, okay, if you bring, okay, John, if you bring, say, $50,000 of business, I'll give you, say, this much incentive. Okay, you will get, say, 1% incentive. Okay, if you bring, say, $500,000 business, you will get 5% incentive. If you bring, say, $1 million business, you will get 12% incentive. Okay, so like we can provide them some sort of incentive, some sort of commission. The more business they bring, the more commission they will get. Okay, so in that case, we can customize the system so that any salesperson, they can come to CRM anytime and they can check that, okay, so far they have bring this much business and that will making their this much commission. So ultimately, if I'm John, so far I have bring, say, $500,000 business to my company, I can quickly go to CRM and I can check, okay, how much commission I make so far. That's all about incentive and commission management. Okay, so there's a formula type thing that you can set up in the customizing, and any person can check their incentive. Depending on the business they brought so far, they can check their incentive. Okay, that's what your incentive and commission management is. Okay, so this is the end of our sales topic, CRM sales assignment. So at the end of every topic, I'll be providing my assignment in this form, what you can see here. So assignment for today's class is, for account and contact management, create a brand new contact and brand new account, okay, with complete data. Okay, and also just play with the search functionality, how we can search contact, how we can search for accounts and all that. Okay, same is the case for activity management. Okay, create and search for new task, interaction log, appointment, email and visit plan. Okay, just create one and also see the search functionality. Also create one opportunity for you, for your newly created customer that you created in here. Okay, create the opportunity for your customer. And also create a quotation and a sales order for the same customer. So if you do this, that's more than enough for the practical. Okay, and because we will be, and first of all, I'll thank you for, because some of our participants yesterday, they did send me a confirmation today that they will be joining next week. And also if others, if you're interested to join, then just send me a confirmation. And because we'll be continuing next week, next weekend, same time. And if you wish to continue, let me know. And because we'll be, all our classes on the weekend will be, say, 2.5 to 3 hours, say 5 to 6 hours every weekend. Okay, so how much you should be spending time on CRM? That's another important question, or which I get, that how much time they should be spending. So if in the online class, if you're spending 5 to 6 hours on the weekend, then during the whole week, ideally you're supposed to spend 5 to 10 hours only. Okay, going through the recording, doing some practicals, that's more than enough. If you spend 5 hours, that's good. If you spend 10 hours, that's best. Okay, so 1 week, this much is enough. Okay, and for today, if you just do this exercise, that's more than enough for you to understand the concept of sales. And I said before that today what we're learning is the different business processes in CRM and how the end users are using it. Okay, and once we complete them, then we'll start customizing. Okay, and this is the end of this topic. So I'm finished for today, and if you have any question regarding any thing we have covered today, so please ask me. So let me take some question. Yeah, there's another one, loyalty management. Thanks, Karim. Yeah, there's another one, loyalty management. There's so many. And there's another one for the web online thing as well.